Hey everybody, it's Rob here at eTroller.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Kuat NV 2.0 two-bike platform rack on our 2020 Subaru Ascent. Now here we got our NV, it's in a gunmetal gray, but it is available in three different colors. So we'll have the gray and orange like we have here, there's a matte black version, and also a metallic black version. So you really just want to pick whichever one matches your Subaru or your bike the best. But I really like our rack because it is a platform style rack, which means that it's gonna hold our bike and there's not gonna be any kind of frame contact. And more or less our bike is sitting on a platform, so it's really nice and sturdy whenever we're going down the road. Now the other nice thing about platform racks is that we do have the option to tilt our bike rack away so we can get access to the rear hatch. Now, obviously we could take our bike off, do all of that, but it's a lot easier if we could just get back there. So we have this lever right here. It's going to be in between the two platforms. And if we pull on that lever, we can actually tilt the bike rack away. Don't have to remove the bikes. And we can open up our rear hatch. Now, I do want to mention that our Ascent, obviously, you know, has an automatic gate on it. So you want to make sure that it's not going to come in contact before you allow it to come open all the way. We already checked. It does get very close, as you can see, to the pedals, but it doesn't make contact with our bike. Now this is a road bike, so you kind of want to keep that in mind if you're using a wider mountain bike or anything like that, but we do have enough room with our road bike to get in here, get what we need, and then we can close the hatch back up. And then once the hatch closes, all we got to do is grab the bike and bike rack and lift back up. There's no levers, nothing else that we really gotta mess with. And you can hear that audible click, so we know that it's locked back in place. Now the way our bike's gonna actually be held down, we're gonna have a strap on the rear wheel. This little gray button here, if we just push in, we can start feeding the strap through, and we can loosen it up. Now, I always recommend loosening up the rear wheel first, because on the front, we're gonna have this large wheel hook. It's gonna go right on the tire, so now we can put our hand on our bike, push the button on top of the hook, extend it out, and now we can remove the bike and take a closer look at the rack. Now with the bike out of the way, if we look at our front wheel tray here, we can see that it's gonna be able to accommodate a wide variety of bikes. That center groove would be great for road bikes like we had on here, so the tire will sit right in the middle. And then the larger outer grooves are going to be great for mountain bikes or bikes that may just have slightly larger tires. Now the ability to carry two bikes with you to and from the trail is really nice. But as you can see, we're adding quite a bit to the back of our Ascent, so I'd like to give you a few measurements. If we measure from the very back of the bumper to the very farthest edge on our rack, it's going to come right about 34 inches. So we don't always have that room. But if we come back to that same lever that we used to tilt our rack away, we can actually tilt it towards the vehicle. And you can already see it saves quite a bit of space. So now if I measure from the back of the bumper, the furthest point is only going to be right about 14 inches. So it really did save quite a bit of space. Now at the same time, you can see we're getting closer to the back of our Subaru, and at the closest point, looks like our rack is going to be right about 5.5 inches. So we still have a decent amount of room here, shouldn't have to worry about any kind of contact. Now another thing a lot of people want to know is the ground clearance. Now that really is going to depend on which hitch you have on your Ascent, but you can see that the shank is going to come straight out of the receiver tube, so we're not losing any ground clearance. But with where our hitch is now, the lowest point of our rack at the very back is going to be right about 21 inches, which is a pretty good measurement. We really shouldn't have to worry too much about bottoming out unless you're going up an extremely steep hill. Now I know everybody wants to make sure that their bike is secure while you're driving, but at the same time, if we stop at the grocery store, if we stop anywhere, we want to make sure our bikes are secure to the rack. Well, Kuat knows that, and they do include some cable locks so we can lock our bikes to the rack and not have to worry as much. And they also include a hitch lock, so not only the bikes are going to be secure to the rack, but the rack is going to be secure to the hitch. And the nice thing is that all the keys are going to be keyed alike, so we don't have to worry about having three different sets of keys with us. Now our MV 2.0 is gonna work with 2-inch hitches, which is nice because that is really common size, and if you have more than one vehicle in your family, chances are this will fit that as well. Now what I really like about it is they have a built-in anti-rattle in the shank of the bike rack. If I shake the bike rack, you can see the entire car is moving, and that's what this knob here at the back is. If we tighten it up, it's going to take all that slack out of the receiver tube, and again, make sure everything's nice and rigid, and we're not going to have to worry about it bouncing around, making a bunch of noise on us. Now, one feature that our bike rack has that really makes it stand out is we're actually going to have this stand here. We can pivot the arm out, and if we loosen up this knob, you can see that it's going to open up. This is going to allow us that we can put our bike down, and it'll securely hold it, so we don't have to have it sitting on the ground. Maybe we have to do a little bit of work on our cables, the chain, or anything like that. It's just going to give us a nice, sturdy, solid point, so we can do a little bit of maintenance on our bike. I know a lot of you want to know exactly how is the rack going to perform when you're driving, so let's see how it does on our test course.
First, we'll take it onto our slalom course. This will show you the side-to-side action, such as making turns or evasive maneuvers. Now we're at the alternating speed bumps. This will show you how it looks driving on uneven pavement or potholes.
I definitely like the Kuat MV 2.0. To me, in my mind, it's definitely a premium rack. It has a lot more user-friendly features than some other platform racks. You know, we have levers and buttons. We don't really have to mess with a bunch of pins and clips, not to mention it comes with all the security and other convenience that a lot of racks don't. But again, I'm Rob here at eTrailer.com, and that'll finish up your look at the Kuat NV 2.0 platform style rack on our 2020 Subaru Ascent.